In this video, I will show how to create and export a band matching. In my database, 47 entries are present. The fingerprint patterns that will be used to construct my table are stored in the fingerprint type experiments RFLP1 and RFLP2. To view the lane of an individual entry, I can click on the colored dot in the corresponding column for that entry. The card can be closed again by clicking in the left upper corner. Before a band matching table can be displayed, a composite data set needs to be defined first. I click on this button in the experiment types panel, select the last option and press OK. I am prompted for my experiment name. The new experiment is added to the experiment types panel. Double-clicking on the experiment opens the composite dataset window. I will include RFLP1 and RFLP2 in this composite dataset. Both experiments are marked with a green V sign. Since a band matching is performed in the comparison window, I first need to make a selection in the main window. I will include all entries in my analysis. With the Ctrl+A shortcut, all entries are selected at once. Pressing this button in the comparisons panel creates a new comparison. Clicking on the eye icon next to RFLP1 displays the RFLP1 patterns in the experiment data panel. Pressing this button calls the band matching dialog. Since I want to perform a band matching on all entries in my comparison, I select the second option. The number of band classes depend on the band matching settings. These settings are called when pressing this button. The optimization is a shift that you allow between any two patterns and within which the program will look for the best possible matching. The position tolerance is the maximal shift you allow between two bands to consider them as matching. I will choose an optimization of 0.5% and a position tolerance of 1%. Pressing OK twice starts the band matching. The band matching for RFLP1 is displayed in the experiment data panel. Band classes are shown as blue lines on the patterns. The band class labels are listed on top of the image. When selecting a band class, the label is highlighted. Double-clicking a label opens a new window containing detailed information on the band class. Optionally, the name of the label can be changed. Bands that are linked to a class are displayed with a blue cross. If I double-click on a band, all bands belonging to the same class are automatically selected. With the zoom sliders, I can zoom in on the image. Removing a band from a class can be done with a simple drag and drop procedure. First, I select the band that was wrongly assigned. I hold the mouse button and drag the band away from the band class. To assign the band to another class, I select the band and drag the band to the new class. To view the band matching in a table, I click on the eye icon next to RFLP combined in the experiments panel. The binary presence-absence table is displayed in the experiment data panel. Since no band matching was yet performed for RFLP2, no band classes are shown for this experiment. To create a band matching for RFLP2, I select the experiment in the experiments panel and press this button again. I select the second option and press OK. The band matching table is updated. To view the numerical intensities of the bands, select this button. To show the quantification in color, press this button. To export the band matching table, select Composite, Export Character Table. This ends this video. Please tune in to our other videos where more functionality is explained. Thank you for watching.